Hey, you guys, time for another book review. So this one right here was another one that wasn't on my 2021 TBR. As I said on that video, there was going to be a lot of books that I just felt like buying for whatever reason that didn't turn up in that video because I didn't have them yet. And this is one of those books. This is a little novel called Sealed by Naomi Booth. Now, I had actually never heard of this book before. I think that I saw this kind of other booktuber, and they had done like this sort of they had all these other ones kind of come on the show and recommend, one book for people that they thought more people should read. And this was one of the guy's recommendations, and he didn't give a huge amount of information about it, but I was like, oh, that sounds kind of interesting. So I went ahead and bought it. Now, I'm gonna say from the outset, I didn't love it, but I really, really like the idea. But I don't know, I'll kind of get into it. Like I said, it's still really good and it's still really fast-paced, and I really enjoyed reading it, but I didn't love it and I felt like it could have been, I don't know, kind of expanded a little bit more. But I'll get into that in a little bit. So this book, it has two different publication dates, the first being 2017 and the second being 2019. So I'm either assuming that's hardback, paperback, or maybe because Naomi Booth is English, maybe it was published in the UK and then published in the US later on. I'm not sure. It has like two different covers. I ordered mine from Amazon, like, American Amazon, obviously. And that's the cover that it was. But when I looked at other covers, it has like a couple other different ones. The odd thing about this, though, is that this is her first novel, I guess, because she had written a bunch of short stories and, various other things. And I guess she's like an academic, so she's written some papers as well. But this is actually her first novel. So even though she is English, the book is set in Australia. I'm not real sure where in Australia, somewhere kind of rural or kind of out in the middle of nowhere in the mountains. And I'm not entirely sure why. It took me a little while because I was like reading it and then I saw like these really weird words and like really weird slang. And so it took me a couple pages. I'm like, wait, what are these people talking about? And then finally I was like, oh, it must be Australia. Now, I have never been to Australia, so I can't really judge on that account. But when I was reading through some of the Goodreads reviews, some of the people who were Australian were kind of like, the slang that she uses is like way over the top. And, people in Australia don't really talk like that. So I can't really judge, like I said, because I've never been there, so I don't know how realistic her dialogue is. And like I said, I'm not entirely sure why it had to necessarily be set in Australia if, if she's never been there or she's not from there or whatever. But like I said, that's neither here nor there. So the story follows a woman named Alice, who is our protagonist through the whole thing, and it's basically told from her point of view. It's also all written in the present tense, which takes me a little bit to get used to, but it didn't bug me after a page or two. So Alice is very, very, very pregnant. And she has a boyfriend slash partner named Pete. They've been together for quite a long time. I guess they grew up next door to one another, so they were kind of childhood friends. And I suppose like after a long time, they ended up getting together, and then she ends up getting pregnant. It wasn't planned. I guess what ends up happening, you find out at some point, is that her mom dies and she's comes for the funeral or whatever, and she's like really bummed out about it. And he and Pete, since he grew up next door, knew the mom, so they just kind of end up having sex like after the funeral, and she gets ends up getting pregnant. And the thing about Alice is that she's very, very introverted, and she's very germ phobic. Like, she thinks that everything in the world is like out to kill her. Like, I think it kind of, I'm not really sure if this happened prior to her getting pregnant. I guess it did because I think Pete makes some kind of jokes about her always being like that. But the thing about it too, this was marketed as like an eco horror. And what's going on in the background, even though it's never really specified outright, is I'm thinking that this is set at some point in the near future. And they never explain what all these catastrophes are, but I'm assuming that they're related to like climate change, because a lot of times people say like how hot it's getting, and like, there's the cities are kind of all coated with smog, and there have been like a lot of flash flooding and like really, really bad thunderstorms and things like that. So I'm assuming that that's what's been going on. So particularly in Australia, and I don't know, it might be the rest of the world too, that's not really gone into all that much. I mean, this echo horror kind of aspect of it is sort of in the background because, like I said, it's all from Alice's point of view, like what she's going through. So, conversations are had about that kind of stuff, but it's not like the main focus. This isn't a real big epic sprawling story or anything. It's basically like her story, and all that stuff is just kind of going on in the background of her life, I guess. So I guess what's been happening is that because, the environment is so bad and like so toxic and everything like that, there have been a lot of relocations. Like they're out, in the cities, they're sending people out to, camps and things like that, where they say it will be safer and there'll be medical care and all these other types of things. Some more like protected, quote unquote, food is sold, which is kind of expensive, which is grown indoors, and supposedly it doesn't have all these toxins on it, and that's indeed the only thing that Alice will eat. But the main thing that our protagonist is worried about, well, she worries about everything, but the main thing that she's worried about is this new disease that is somehow, like, I guess it's somehow related to all of these environmental kind of factors, like all these environmental disasters that have been going on. And this new disease is called cutis. And basically, what it is it makes your skin grow like really, really fast and seal up all of your orifices. Now, you can probably imagine how that might go. And she does actually, because Alice, prior to her getting pregnant and moving out to this remote area, which I'll get into in a minute, but she had been working for kind of a, I think it's like a housing commission or some kind of thing where they're helping to house people that are, that are poor. And what seems to be happening is that people are getting this disease and are either essentially suffocating, or in one case that she mentions, a dude's, this is pretty gross, but the dude's butthole seals closed and he just vomits shit until he dies. So, people's eyes are sealing shut and, they're blind. So it's not a good situation. The thing about it though is that there's so much other terrible shit going on the planet that cutis, even though it kind of made a big splash like when it originally, came on the scene and people were dying in it from it in like spectacular ways. But because there's so much other bad shit going on, it's kind of like people have sort of forgotten about it a little bit. And it's also, too, that if you are able to access medical care, as in if you have the money to access medical care, then, you can have a surgeon like cut away the skin and you'll be fine. Like it won't kill you. So it's primarily, just like most illnesses, killing people who are at the lower end of the economic ladder because they can't afford to get medical treatment for it. And so they end up being essentially sealed shut inside their own bodies. So because Alice is so freaked out about this and she thinks that the government or whoever is kind of covering up how many deaths there have been from this disease because she worked in this particular, she had this particular line of work, so she saw a lot of cases firsthand where this had happened to poor people and it wasn't reported on. So she's basically getting all up in this conspiracy that it's this big cover-up. So she, now that she's pregnant, she's super, super paranoid, not only about that, but about all kind of other toxins. I think, though, that she was always kind of like germ-phobic, but once that cutis thing started to happen, I think she kind of focused all of her fears around that, and she kind of associated all the other environmental factors, like all the other toxins or poisons or whatever in the air, like the smog in the city, with maybe being the cause of that. So because her boyfriend, Pete, who's kind of like a happy, everything's gonna be okay type of guy, he kind of thinks that maybe she's getting a little too paranoid about this stuff and she's getting all into conspiracy theories. So I guess prior to the events of the book, he has convinced her, hey, we need to get out of the city. You're getting too obsessed, you know, because she has like massive files about all these people that died of this disease. And she's pretty much thinks about it all the time. And even other people like where she worked came up to her and said, yeah, you need to like tone, like dial that back a little bit because it's just stressing you out and that's not good for you and it's not good for the baby and whatever. So Pete convinces her to move out to this little bitty remote town, which in hindsight was probably like the worst fucking thing that they possibly could have done because yeah, there's no smog or anything like that out here in this little bitty thing. But because there seems to be, you know, a lot of poverty, people being moved out to, you know, various camps. Like I said, this stuff about the, you know, the pandemic or whatever is not real gone into. It's just kind of like a background thing. So you're not really entirely sure what all the parameters of it are, which is one of the things that I would criticize about it. I kind of think I wanted a little bit more world building. I mean, it's a pretty short book. I think it's like only maybe 200 pages, maybe not even that long. And it almost seems more like a short story, which I guess this makes sense because, you know, Naomi Booth was mostly known for short story writing. This is her first novel. So it does have some world building, but it's not like the main focus. And I feel like there's not enough of it to get like a context as to what exactly is going on. There's also something, and this is actually not a criticism because I thought this was an interesting aspect of the book, is that through the whole thing, and even after it ends, you're really not sure. I mean, you know that bad shit is happening. Like, you know this cutest disease is real because you do see, like, some people get it and, like, some people that have died of it. But you're never entirely sure if Alice is justified in her terror of it. Because there are some things that happen that could say, yeah, the shit's as bad as she thinks it is. But then there's other shit that's like, maybe it's not as bad as she thinks it is. And maybe she's just super, super paranoid and it's making her see things in a particular way that maybe, you know, maybe things aren't like that. So I thought that was a really interesting aspect. And like I said, it's not really resolved. I will say, like, it's a kind of a strangely paced novel because pretty much the first three quarters of it are basically Alice moving to this new place. She discovers pretty quickly that, and she begins to suspect that there's been a cutis outbreak in this town that no one is talking about because, you know, she can't check in at a doctor. She can't get a midwife. You know, everybody said, oh, all the doctors are leaving or we're only doing emergencies, you know, because we're so behind. And people say things to her about, you know, oh, the outbreak, but they won't tell her what it is. Everybody seems mildly hostile towards them because they came from the city. There's this old guy, like the house they live in, they don't even have a phone yet, which seems really dumb because like I said, she's about to pop, like pretty much. I think when they move to the house, she's like due in 3 or 4 weeks or something like that. So she's really, really close. So they don't have the phone installed yet. And, you know, they go to the nearest neighbor who's like a mile or a mile and a half away, who they want to see if he has a phone so they can use it. And the dude is just like this cranky, like abusive woman who won't let them in. And so everybody just seems vaguely hostile and you're not entirely sure why. And like I said, there's a whole background thing of like people being moved out to camps, like outsides, because they'll be safer out there. And she's like wigging out about that. So, but like I said, there's still some ambiguity over whether she's overreacting or whether her reaction is completely justified. Because what happens at the end, I mean, I hesitate to say, it's like, I don't want to necessarily like, I don't think spoiler alerts are really all that relevant in this case, because as soon as you hear, you know, that the main character is hugely pregnant, and then you hear about like the main kind of plot mechanism of this thing being this illness that seals you closed, like seals all your orifices closed, you can pretty much see where that's going. You know what I mean? Because as soon as I read about that disease, I was like, oh, I can see how this is going to end up. And it kind of does. The last maybe 30, 40 pages of this, because like I said, the pacing is kind of straight. It's like most of it, you're just following her and her getting paranoid and you not being entirely sure what's going on. And maybe she's just wigging out about nothing, or maybe she's making a bigger deal about it than it is. But, you know, it's still like people are still kind of sketchy and you're not really sure what's going on. But then like the last 30, 40 pages, it like really like ramps up, like when she starts going into labor, and then all kind of like horrible, horrible things like happen and just in this massive cascade. But the, like I said, the end of it, when she actually has the baby, and has all this problem about it, I wasn't sure if the thing that she was like worried about, you know what I mean, with the baby being born, actually happened, because it seemed like she had her, like her friend came over and found her and was like helping her out and whatever. And her friend didn't really seem to see anything all that unusual, but I didn't know if the friend was just trying to like keep her calm because everybody knew that she was like that. So it's like, it really like leaves it ambiguous. Like I said, like whether, you know, whether she was just paranoid or whether this really, really horrible shit was happening. Now, if you are squeamish about childbirth type stuff, the last 30 or 40 pages of this book are probably not for you, because it's pretty graphic and it's pretty fucking gross. And it's, you know, it's fairly accurate too, but obviously it's described in like really, really excruciating detail, and it's like really, really nasty. So, you know, if you don't really want to read about that, then probably you might want to skip this one, or at least skip over those pages, because it's pretty gross. Like the rest of it is not all that gross. Like there's like little gross bits in there, but yeah, that last bit was pretty fucking nasty. And you can probably, like I said, you can probably imagine pregnant women, ceiling disease, you know, just kind of let your imagination run wild. And yeah, it really does get pretty gross. But like I said, I liked this book. It's very fast paced. You know, like I said, the pacing's kind of strange. It seems like the bulk of the book is just kind of her becoming more and more paranoid. But then like the last part of it is like happens, it seems like it happens like really, really quick. And like all of these horrible things like happen in like super quick succession. So, you know, that's a little strange. It didn't bother me all that much. So it's not like real evenly paced. I would have liked maybe it to be like fleshed out a little bit more, not so much the characters, because they're pretty well fleshed out, but just what exactly is going on in the wider world, like what the environmental, like you can kind of figure it out like from the context clues, but it was never really established. Like when they move to this little bitty remote village or town or whatever, it's never really established like why everybody is so shitty towards them, why, you know, there's no hospitals anymore, why they walk around in the town and like everyone's inside. It's like you're presuming that it has to do with the environmental shit, but it's like, it's, I don't know, it's not really made clear. And also, like I said, I thought when I read this that Naomi Booth was Australian, would, you know, why she said it in Australia. But then I found out later that she was English, and I couldn't really figure out why she would set it in Australia if she, you know, I mean, it seems like the story would work the same no matter where you set it, like as long as it was kind of like a remote place that, you know, you didn't have a phone and blah, 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 you know, you could set that anywhere. So I'm not really entirely sure why she chose Australia, but, you know, maybe I'm sure she had her reasons. So I'm not really questioning it. I'm just saying that, you know, and I'm not from Australia either, so I don't know how accurate her portrayal of the Australians in the book are. According to some other reviews I've read of people who were Australians, they thought that she kind of went a little try hard with all the slang, and she's like, you know, we don't really talk like that, and, you know, she just kind of went over the top with it, in their opinion. So I don't know. I can't really judge that for myself. But like I said, this was a pretty decent read. I really liked the idea. I liked the idea of like a, you know, a disease that would seal all your orifices shut, which is pretty horrifying. And like I said, the last 30, 40 pages, dynamite, super gross and shit like that. And I kind of liked, even though Alice isn't necessarily a likable character because she's just super paranoid and fucking worried about everything, I still kind of felt sorry for her in a way, even though she's not real likable. Like she's, I don't know, it's really hard to explain. And some of the thought processes that she had, I kind of related to. So I kind of related to her a little bit, but she's also kind of awful. And also her boyfriend, Pete, even though he's kind of like this laid back, hey, everything's cool type of guy, he seemed a lot of times in their interactions to be really kind of condescending toward her and like saying she was always being, you know, paranoid and her and her conspiracy theories. Like he would kind of laugh it off, but it almost seemed like he was talking to her like she was a child a lot of times. So he wasn't super likable either. Also, you find out later that he'd been like fucking around on her and whatnot. So that made him even less likable. But, you know, none of the characters in this are really all that likable. Other than she has a friend. Well, she kind of has a friend named Mara. And she's not in it a lot, but she's actually pretty likable and turns out to be like a good character. But, you know, and I've said this before, it doesn't have to be. The characters don't have to be likable. I don't really have a problem with that. And I didn't find her that unlikable. She was a little frustrating, but, you know, I didn't hate her or, you know, want her to, I didn't want to punch her or anything like that. I could see where she was coming from, but it's like her thought process has made her a frustrating character, if that makes any sense. But yeah, like I said, probably solid, three and a half stars, something like that. It's a good, fast paced read. Good idea. I wish it had been like kind of fleshed out a little more, like the world building and stuff, just so I had a better handle on what was going on. But other than that, you know, it was a pretty decent read. So if it sounds like something that you'd kind of be into, then check it out. And I will see you guys on the next review. Bye.